Welcome to my Unreal Engine for tutorial series on how to make an inventory system. Last time we left off with this thing. So if we toggle your inventory, you can see this little an inventory action bar, but it not looks so good. So the reason is, open your inventory slot, and we have done a simple mistake. After the auto sizing, just click on this little boolean because we want to auto size it, right? Hit compile. So that's first mistake. The second one is, we also want to set this toggle opacity back to on when we don't want to inspect it. I mean, don't want to set the action bar. So that's these two things. First is click, make sure whenever your inventory action is valid and you want to remove it, you can set the toggle opacity back to on. And also the auto size event is also ticked. So let's get started. First things first, let's inspect it. You can see we have added one thing. So if you click on this, you can see we have added this little action bar, and if you click on again, it's gone. But we have all 8 slots and it's only present on first slot, and all 7 slots are empty. So if you click on this, it is showing that examine, but we don't want that. We only want for this one, the present slot. So if you click on this empty slots, nothing would happen, right? So that's also we want to overcome. So how are you gonna do that? Open your inventory slots. Before doing these things, what we want to do, make a little room here and just double click to add a reroute node so it looks more clean. In here, hit branch. Okay, and get your slot structure. Right click to split. You can see we have another slot structure. Right click to split it again. Now we want to get the name. So if you remembered, I have told you to inside your slot structure, not this one, the item structure, sorry. Inside here I have told you to make this item name default value to none, and we're gonna use that inside here. So by default, if you don't have any slot, so the item value name is none. So get your name and get equal to text. Yep. And from here, make literal text. And this would be none. Yep, right. Make sure you don't have any spaces. You can have just simply none. Make sure this is save to this one. The none. The first letter is capital, all third is small. So make sure you spell this correctly, because otherwise it won't work. So if it's not null, so grab this exclamation mark. If it's not null, then we want to get that inspection, the action bar, because if it's our slot is empty, then we don't want that action bar, right? So we're gonna check this first. If it false, then we don't want to do anything. So let's check out this. So you can click on this, nothing is happening because we don't have any slot. But if you open this up, inspect it, we have added a herb. So you can see it is spawning for this only, the herb, but for not for this. So right, so we have done this thing. Now for the inspection part. So how are you gonna do that? Close this slot because we don't need that. What we actually need is this, the inventory actions item. If you remembered on the previous lecture, we have made this this event, the examine. So inside the examine, what we want to do, first things first, we want to get that inspect message. So open that, simultaneously open that one also, the UI, the inspection blueprint interface, the interface we have created on the previous series, the item inspection, and that have three functions, the inspect, interact, and receive trace. So we have done this thing. So what we want to do, first we want to check if we are inspecting from our UI or from our action button. So how are we gonna check that? So add an input, and the boolean value should be from UI, right? So we want to check if it's from UI or it is from our the inspection item. The second we want is the UI, and this UI would be your the inventory UI, right? The inventory window. Yes, this one, object reference, the inventory window UI object reference. It compiled. Let me just double check it so we don't mess up with that. Yes, the inventory window. So we have done this thing. Just close this inspect element. And what we want to do, whenever we click on this examine, we want to inspect it. So inspect message, the inspect message, you can see this, right? So grab this now. And how do you gonna inspect it? So if you remember the previous videos, you can see we have made a studio actor, and from that we're gonna inspect it. So let's just spawn an actor. So spawn actor from class, and for the transform, make a transform, and for the x values, make it so large that it was gonna spawn outside your world. So 1 and 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0, make sure this x value is bigger enough so that our spawn actor would spawn a little bit more fast, a little bit more far, and the class would be your studio actor. The studio actor we have just made. So now we can see if you get this return value and attach it to target, hit compile, all the things are gone. Now we need a player. So how are you gonna get a player? So it's good to get a player. So delete this tick, we don't need that. We don't need this pre-construct also. What we need on the construct event, cast to player character. My player character was third person, right? Cast to your whatever the player character you are using, and get the player character, and just promote it, because it's good to have variables. Player ref, I'm just gonna call it player reference. So for the examine part, the player would be your player reference, right? And get the slot, and from that right click and split it out. If you split it out again, you can see all this thing. So for the item name, this one. For the item description, this one. For the item name and description, we have done this thing. For the mesh, we have to set a mesh inside here so that we can set it. So how are you gonna do that? So open your slot. On the inventory, we have made this item structure. Just add a variable. If you remember, we have said that we can add this variable on whenever we needed. So the variable would be your mesh. I'm just gonna call it mesh, and this would be a static mesh. So type would be a static mesh. Yep, this one, the static mesh object reference. Make sure you select the static mesh, not the actor, not the component, the static mesh object reference. Save. So if you now see, we have this structure of mesh. So attach it to here. It compiled, and we are spawning this actor from our UI. So click on this UI. So that's why it makes more sense. And the UI, what the UI would be? So the UI would be your inventory UI. So how are you gonna get that. So make a Roma here and get widget of class. Get all widgets of class, right? And we want to get the widgets of class of our inventory window. And get a copy of the first and attach it to here, because there would be only one widget present inside your inventory UI. So get the first instance, because there would be only one instance, and attach it to here. So we have done this thing. Now what we want to do, we are now present on the UI in input mode, because we have done all this thing on UI. So we want to set back to game mode, right? So set input mode to game only, because we want to set to game mode, because we want to inspect it, we want to rotate it, and it will gonna do on the world. This is why we need a game only input. And for that, just get the player controller. If you are using a different controller, then you might have to cast, or you don't want to cast it, minimize it. So we have done all these things. Now what? Open your items, the items we have just created. So inside your master object, you can see this one, the from UI and this UI selected, hit compile. But we don't want that right inside here. We only want, if we click on by inspecting our UI from our action bar. So this is why this would be false and this would be null. What we actually want is on your begin play, where was it? Just right click and begin play. Yep. So we want the begin play. So set this item. So grab this item, and the item would be your this structure item. So get item structure, split it out, yes, and set one this. So how do you gonna set that? So grab this and set static item, static mesh. Yep. And the static mesh would be your this one, this static mesh. So on event begin play, this would be done. So we have done this thing. Now where was the inspect? Yep. So we have done this thing. Just close that up. So we have done all this thing. Now what we want to do, we want to use the studio actor. So open this studio actor, and you can see we have done the from UI. So get that and promote it to variable, and we're gonna call this is from UI. Just this variable we have just promoted, and attach it to here. So on the inventory interact, if it's true, so hit branch, and the is from UI. So if you inspect it, and if you inspect it back, if it's from UI, then we want to set the function, the UI to something called inventory, because we want to set the all these things inside the inventory window. So we want to set the input mode to inventory window. So what we're gonna do, rather than checking it here, attach it to here. Rather than checking it to here, we want to check it after removing parent, destroying actor, right? So after destroying actor, we want to check. Okay. Yep. So cast not, no, let me just see that. Yep. So on this one, so how are you gonna do that? So from that inventory, get, and I just want to promote this one to variable, and I'm gonna call it my inventory. Okay, click on this inventory. So this we don't need that. So attach it to here, and you can see if we are inspecting by clicking on interact, then this would be null. So we also want to check that. So how are you gonna do that? So from that, get this inventory and right click to convert validate, because we want to check because it could be null or not. So check this. So if it's null or not, if it's true, then we want to set input mode to UI only. The UI we want to set it this one, and the player controller will be get the player controller. Also show the mouse cursor, right? And tick this because we want to show the mouse cursor. I double click to set this one, hit compile and save. Go back to your inventory action. So we don't want to show the mouse cursor whenever we inspecting. So just grab a node from this player controller and show mouse cursor, it would be false because we don't want to show mouse cursor whenever we are inspecting. This one, hit compile, save. And I think this odd thing should be do. So where the all the things went? Okay. Oh, on the master object. Yep. We have done this thing. So close this one and close minimize that. Open your master object. Remember on begin play. Where was it? We have done this thing. We don't need actually this. Delete this. On the item, get that static mesh. And get this item structure and set members inside your item structure, and the members would be just click on this and you can see all the things. So what we want to do, we want to set this mesh inside here, hit compile and save, and this should work now. So you can see if you inspect this, you can inspect this from this also. If you close, this is gone, and if you hit tab, the inventory spawned. If you click on this and click on this examine, you can see, but we can't do examine. Why is that? And if you click on this, okay, so on Studio Actor, let me see where we went wrong. Okay, we want to attach this one, hit compile. Minor mistakes. Let's check this out. So we can inspect this from this. Also examine. So we can inspect this from a UI also. If you press E again, then it is setting back this one to the final mode. We don't want that. So how are you gonna fix that? Okay. So problem was inside this get all widget of class, you can see this top level only. Make sure it hit false, otherwise it only gonna check for the top level widgets, but we don't want that. We want to check for every layer of Z order. So make sure it turned on false, and this is all it, and now it gonna work. So you can see if I hit play, inspect it, you can inspect it here. Hit E to close that. Hit again for tab for inventory. click on this to add this exam in, and click on this exam in so you can examine it inside here. If you hit E again, you can see we have focused back on our inventory, right? If you click on this, it will. And now if you hit tab, we have back. There is a slight problem. If you inspect it, you can see our character is animating. It means it is not paused, right? But we want to pause this character as well. As well, we are inspecting our item. So how are you gonna do that? So on the inventory event action of master object, so whenever we inspect our inventory, right, we want to do this one, the inspection, and from the inspection we want to do these things. So whenever we are inspecting, we want to set the dilation of 0. So open your studio actor, and whenever you are doing the inspection, make sure the set dilation to 0, right? And inside your inventory interact, hit branch, it compiles it, and set for is from UI. So it is from UI, so we're gonna check it is from UI or not. If it's not from UI, then yeah, whenever we remove that studio, we want to set the dilation back to normal. So grab this and set to 1 and hit attach it to here, save. So let's check this out if it's working or not. So right now if we hit E, our player is stopped animating, you can see that, and you can inspect it, you can E again, so it works fine. So our game pause is working fine whenever we are inspecting. Also if you hit inventory, it's paused. You can see it examine, hit E again to examine it. If you close this one, then it goes to pause because we have opened our inventory. So if you hit tab, then our inventory is gone and our player is animating again. So do all things while pausing, it's good, right? So we have done these things, hit save. So this is all for the inventory inspect. On the next episode, we're gonna learn of combining the items. So this is all for it now. Thank you so much guys for watching, and bye bye.